All right, take like 1,000. I'm gonna try to do this in one take. Oh, my dog is freaking out. Okay. Spooky here. This is my hatred assassin guide. A lot of people have been wanting this. There aren't actually any real hatred guides on YouTube that I've seen, so I thought, yeet, I'll throw it up there. A lot of people wonder how I do the DPS I do. Disclaimer, this is not going to have anything to do with objective play in Warzones at all. The only time I ever play the objective is when it's fours, because that's just like do DPS pressure and kill shit, so yeah. Another disclaimer, this is mostly going to be oriented towards regs, simply because if you're going into fours, you probably already know how to play the class. And on top of that, my sub ran out before I stopped, or started recording gameplay. So I don't actually have any ranked 4s footage. I have reg 4s, which I'll throw up at some point and just like talk over it and explain what I'm doing and why I'm doing it and stuff. So yeah, this guide is also going to be in two parts. So this part is like the theory of the class, the general overview, strengths, how to exploit them, weaknesses, how to work around them. Stuff like that. I'm gonna go over the utilities, the stats, and then I'm gonna explain how to do like good numbers with this spec. Another thing, the second part of this guide is gonna be a walkthrough of a war zone, so I'm gonna just commentate over footage of me playing Warzone. It won't be one I've already uploaded either. It'll be something new. I'm just gonna pick it randomly from my like captures folder, and I'll pause at certain points. I'll explain what I'm doing. When I make mistakes, I'll point out the mistakes. I'll explain why it was bad. I'll explain how I could have got more damage out of doing something else. And so that second part is going to be very important, especially if you already kind of know how to play the class. This will be like useful, but the second part is going to be what's really, really useful, and I'm going to post both like back to back. I don't want to make it like one video because that'll be real long, but yeah. So guess we can dive into what this class is, what the spec is. So hatred, it's a pressure DPS spec, which means it's like fluff, so dot spread. A really nice thing about it is your spread move doesn't have a cooldown. You can just spam it, and it's actually a really good AoE move. So because of that, people think it's easy to play. It kind of is. It's easier than, like, I don't know, engineering or something. But at the same time, there are like three or four good hatred assassins on Starforge. So it's actually really, really underrepresented spec. Almost every assassin on my server at least plays deception, and the few hatred ones. There are a few who know what they're doing, but for the most part, it's just people who are like kind of like trying it out. Nobody really wants to main the spec, and I'll explain why. So, alright, so first thing, stats. This is my unbolstered. It's pretty bad. Yeah, can't afford augments out here. The proper setup for stats, try figured that out, and I'll put that up. Ideally, you want enough alacrity for the second tier, which I think is like 1860 or something. And then the rest go into crit and like power and mastery and all that shit. So yeah, this is what I got. It's pretty awful. I just kind of mix like, I don't know, everything. Next thing, we got the utilities. So the
This part's pretty easy for the most part, except at the end you'll see. So first in Skillful, we got Avoidance. This reduces the cooldown of Jolt and Unbreakable Will and Force Speed. Big thing about this is Force Speed. It lets you get into like combat situations faster, increases your uptime. It's just overall good to have. Another thing, Jolt. This is really important in fours when you're always like interrupting on cooldown. It's a big deal. Unbreakable Will. This is another huge DPS increase. Unfortunately, a lot of the time your stun break is actually going to be used offensively, and I'll show a video of that. And then the reason the stun break gets used offensively is if you have someone dotted up and like three people just jump to you and you get stunned and you're at 20% and you have that stun break, if you break and spread, that's like, it's like 120k damage right there from using your stun break in that scenario. It's definitely worth it. In fours though, like don't do that, but you know, this is mostly for eights, so it's gonna be really useful. Lambaste is the next big thing. This is huge. Lacerate damage increase is a guaranteed DPS increase by a lot. In a perfect scenario, Lacerate should be your most used move. Like if you look at your move usage, Lacerate will probably be around like 65% in a like perfect game where you get a lot of cleave. So it's really nice to have that damage buff. The other things in Skillful aren't really useful at all, actually. In Masterful, Fade reduces the cooldown of Force Cloak and extends its duration by 5 seconds. The only important thing is the cooldown. You get a 1-minute Force Cloak, which is huge. Force Cloak can also be used offensively, which I'll get to in a second. And that's huge. It's a huge DPS increase to have this. Also, another big thing, being able to escape combat. Really useful, especially when you're in a situation where if you die, you could get a full door. And full doors are like, that just kills your DPS. Like, everyone knows how it feels to get a full door. It's awful. It's the worst feeling ever. It's just disease. So, yeah, this helps avoid that. And then Obfuscation. This is really nice because you get a movement speed increase. Stealth level doesn't matter except for, like, daily farming if you do that. And then everything else in the Masterful section is pretty bad. The only thing I could ever see using would maybe be like, I don't know, speed surge, but like why? Then we go to Heroic. Heroic's kind of tricky. Heroic and Legendary are both tricky. It's not as like straightforward as like this is guaranteed DPS increase. This stuff, it gets debatable. So the guarantee for Heroic is Emersion. Immersion is necessary for like all assassins. You need this. Having a 15 second like movement impairing thing, like that's beautiful. You get like rooted, you get slowed, you just pop 4 speed and you're good to go. It's great. Immersion is like necessary always. Now here's where it gets kind of tricky. Deciding between Shroud of Madness and Dark Stability. Shroud of Madness means that you get 2 seconds of Force Shroud when you use Force Cloak. So when you vanish, if you have it, like normally it's just whatever, you leave combat. If you're dotted, you're still dotted. If you're like if you have debuffs, they're still there. You can still get hit by Force and Tech AoE. And that's kind of lame. Now, if you have Shroud of Madness, that doesn't happen. Because when you use Force Cloak, you get that immunity and you get the cleanse. Alternatively here, you can use Dark Stability, which is what I use. The reason for that, well, Dark Stability gives you 6 seconds of immunity to stun, sleep, incapacitating, all that. And then Legendary. Legendary is where it gets kind of more debatable. There are like three people on the server who play a lot of Hatred Sin and who are good, like really good at Hatred Sin, really know what they're doing. And I think all of us use different utilities in Legendary. But this is my setup. So, Reaper's Rush. This one isn't the most important between the two, but Reaper's Rush is really, really nice for two reasons. First off, it procs your assassinate as soon as you go in, so we have a lot of lag. I live in like Yeehaw land right now, so I'm chilling at like this, and it's always like this. But yeah, that Reaper's Rush is super useful. You get assassinate right away. It's a DPS increase objectively. It's useful that way. Another thing, and so the big like the worst part about Hatred is as a melee class, you kind of get fucked a lot of the time. Like Hutball, when people are running around, a lot of the situations where range just is superior to melee because you can't access all your targets, you can't discharge people unless they're within 10 meters, and that's not gonna happen in a Quesh ball where everyone's up on top. I mean, you can jump and do it if you time it right, but like it's just so inconvenient. Reaper's Rush means that if you kill a target after you teleport to them, you get the cooldown, but just reset, and then you can teleport again. That's a huge deal. It's really useful. Gives you a lot more mobility. You're able to move around a lot easier in war zones. It's really useful, really nice to have. Retaliatory grip. This is an objective DPS increase. You get 50% damage reflection for 12 seconds, which, if you're getting fucked up in a group and you're taking a lot of force and tech, you're getting a lot back, especially if a lot of people are on you, and if you have healers too, and it doesn't matter if you take more than would normally kill you, you can get some pretty good DPS from it. In a couple games I've had, it accounts for like 300-400 DPS, so it's always useful. Another option is Phasing Phantasm. This thing, I use it in ranked. In ranked, I swap Reaper's Rush for Phasing Phantasm, and the reason for that is 60% DR while you're in 4 speed, so it's really nice. You get 2 seconds of like a huge defense increase that you need. Otherwise, as this class, you're gonna get messed up. So let's talk about the
So, first thing, strengths of the class, or spec, highest DPS in the game. Nothing does more DPS than Hatred. It's very, very good, very powerful, great for pressuring healers. Nothing will do as much DPS in the perfect scenario. And when we get to the weaknesses, I'll explain why it's actually kind of rare for Hatred to have the best potential DPS in a given situation. But yeah, it's a big strength, the raw DPS. Like, it's just kind of crazy how much you can do with this class if you know what you're doing. Another strength, force regeneration is like stupid easy with this class. If you have zero force and you saber strike once, you're good to go to do whatever you want. Like, it's so easy. You can indefinitely use your AoE move. You just like use Lacerate, use Eradicate when it procs, use Death Field when it's off cooldown, use Lacerate more, and you can just keep doing that forever. Like, force regen with this class is never a problem, ever. It's not like with IO where if you fuck up once, then you're like done for half a minute. This class is really, really forgiving in the regard of force regen, as it should be. Because, well, you'll see why. Another strength, you have a lot of offensive options. Like, you get stun resists, you get your DCDs should almost always be used offensively, but you get mileage out of them in a way that other classes don't really Like, the stun resist is huge. You get to jump into a group, you get to spread, and no one can do anything about it for like 3 seconds, so that's pretty cool. Another strength, it's really good in fours. If you ever run into double melee, whichever team has the hatred sin is gonna win, unless they like suck or something, and they don't in like group fours. So yeah, hatred is pretty good for that. It's a very, very good pressure class. It's the best pressure class in the game. Now, moving on to the weaknesses. This class is pretty weak in a lot of ways. That's probably why nobody plays it. First off, it's the squishiest spec in the game. It's even worse than PT, and it's like kind of a lot worse than PT. You have no defensive cooldowns, and the ones that you do, if you're not using them offensively, you're killing your DPS anyway. So it's a lose-lose in that regard. Ever since I've been in Pwn, though, ever since I stepped on that Pwnography casting couch, I've always been queuing with fire healers, shoutouts to Bunny, Sass, Synergy. When Derwin's healing, he's fire. I don't even know if he's in Pwn, though. He might just be doing his own thing, but yeah. So I always queue with the healer and tanks and stuff, because I mean I can't even solo queue because I'm not subbed. But yeah. If you don't have that though, survivability is going to be a really, really big problem. And you're going to have to know how to pick your time to die. Like, pick when, okay, if I die here, it'll save me time, because like stealthing out and healing up is going to be a pain anyway. So I might as well, and then hopefully the door's fine, or maybe you're on Hypergate where the door doesn't even matter, and Aldessin, and just die as much as you want. But survivability can kind of hurt DPS, especially compared to Madness, which has a lot more survivability, especially because LOS and like kiting does not kill DPS as it does with hatred. Another big weakness is you can't really like handle 1v2 situations and stuff like that on your own. It's kind of hard unless they're really bad. It's not like concealment or something where you're like always safe. You're always in a pretty bad spot with hatred. Another thing, hatred suffers from melee-itis, as all melee classes do, where in certain games you just get no opportunity to do anything. You don't get any dot spread chances. You don't get you can't tab discharge if they're more than 10 meters away, which in Quesh Ball that happens all the time, and all Hut Ball that happens if they have a lot of ranged on their team. It's really painful when that happens. Really not fun. Oh yeah, big thing too, especially when you're playing against good people. Hatred is very easy to shut down. If Insta-whirl is sitting you, you're fucked. Like, he's just gonna cuck you all game, and there's nothing you can do, and you just have to sit there and take it. I don't even have any footage of it because I get like so dead inside when Insta's on me that I just don't like rec like I don't save the recording. It's awful. It's so awful. There's nothing you can do. You can get taunted on cooldown. You get pulled because you're melee. When you get pulled away from everyone, you're in trouble. Everything just sucks about getting tanked as hatred. You don't really have any options. You can't CC the way Deception can. Yeah, another con. If you like to play objectives, don't play hatred. This class is for one thing, and that's pressure. That's all it's good for, and it's better than anything else in the game at that. So, just do that. Don't ever try to play objectives with this class. Like, just go Deception if that's your thing. Yeah. So, with that out of the way, we can get into how to go about like actually dealing the most damage. So the general. Today, oh, an evil evolution. moving along to like the mentality of how to play this class and how to get the most out of it, you need to think of every war zone like it's, you get 600 seconds. Do as much as you can in that time. Make as much out of that as you can. Make every second and all of your like 436 or whatever it is, GCDs, make that all count as much as possible. Make everything meaningful. Every movement, everything should be contributing to your end DPS. Mistakes happen. I've had maybe like two games where I think every GCD was perfect, but and like I've played a lot of games, so yeah, mistakes will happen, but you can play pretty optimally after you get used to doing the stuff that I'm going to show you coming up now.
You're seeing here is just footage from a Hypergate I played. It's a really good start to a game that I just found. So here, open with Eradicate, Deathfield, root him, discharge. Now I get the spread. Run ahead, spread again, spread again. That's over 100k damage. Easy, spread again. That's like 300k actually, probably, from all this. And then here, I go into lacerates, break that so I can just keep doing DPS. Make sure everyone's dotted. I notice their healer isn't, so I'm gonna go over there, dot that healer up, hit as many people with the death field as possible, keep pressing lacerate. Now I'm low on force, so I'm gonna eradicate right now. So what you're seeing here is pretty like textbook hatred play. Generally, cleave is the best scenario. If you do have to get in the 1v1, which I'll show in a second, you want it to be like worth it. So yeah, here's this.
Right, so now we have footage of a 1v1. So I'm just cleaving these people, and I see someone isn't dotted up. This person's gonna die, so I might as well switch targets, and I do. I've watched this person earlier in the game, and I'm pretty sure I can kill them pretty quickly. See, they're not doing any damage, and I already took like half their health. Another target gets on me. This target also isn't a threat, so I'm just gonna kill them pretty quick. I think this takes like 10 GCDs or something. Anyway, it's an efficient 1v1 because my DPS doesn't drop below 10k. I don't think, I hope not. And then that's over. And then I go back to this target, dot them up. I should switch here. I don't know. And then I switch. And then I spread.